Hey, do you know what time it is? Oh, that's right. It's plastic surgery time. Infantile hemangioma. Do you know what that is?
I do.
And at the end of this video, so will you. In today's video, we're going to talk about infantile congenital hemangioma, one of the congenital hemangiomas or vascular malformations, not to be confused with the non-involuting congenital hemangioma, the NICH, or the rapidly involuting congenital hemangioma, the RICH. What is an infantile hemangioma? It is a clustering, a gathering of vessels that occurs on an infant, usually with infantile congenital hemangiomas. There'll be a speck, maybe a red speck, not seen at birth, shortly after birth, but within 1 to 3 months, something that increases rapidly in size. Who gets it? Well, that's pretty easy. Infants, infantile, not a hard stretch. Where can an infantile congenital hemangioma, boy is that a mouthful, occur? Anywhere. Nose, near the eye, the head, the hand, the chest, the arm. It can even occur internally by the liver, by internal organs. This is what makes it such a difficult thing to deal with sometimes. Anywhere in the body, it can occur and it can cause problems. When does this occur? It occurs in infants, as we said, usually at birth, a pinpoint. By month 1 to 3, it starts increasing in size. Rapid exponential growth. This can occur up to about a year. At about a year to year and a half, it stabilizes. Many patients, over 70 to 80%, by 6 years of age, the hemangioma will involute or go away by itself. So conservative therapy or not doing anything can be done for those patients. Why do infantile congenital hemangiomas occur? We don't know. There's some studies that state that it may be secondary to the placenta of the mother transferring over, though that's not 100% the case. But either way, it really hasn't changed our treatment or given us anything to help prevent them. Now, for the answer to the question you've been patiently waiting for throughout this whole video. How? How do we what? How do we treat them? It depends. It depends on the location, the size, and some other factors. Monitoring, which just means we watch them. We could see what happens as the baby grows older and at a year and a half, see how large it is, and know most of the time this will involute or go away by itself. There is surgery. Surgery is now rarely used because we have other options, but in certain locations, surgical excision may be necessary. This is not a simple operation as a hemangioma is full of blood vessels and can bleed. Injection. Some surgeons will inject with steroids, which does help shrink the hemangioma. Though just like surgery, injection into these vascular bloody lesions can also cause a problem. And the last treatment which we use, which many times becomes the first line of therapy, is the use of a beta blocker called propranolol. It's a medication used to slow heart rate. Studies have shown, and we've seen it, decrease the size of hemangioma during that exponential growth phase. At the doses given to babies, it is not harmful, and many babies do very well and can prevent surgery in locations which normally would come to surgery. And a very important point which I didn't discuss, some hemangiomas can cover significant areas, and if those occur, we need to do other studies, CAT scans or MRIs, to make sure other internal organs or the brain are not affected. Infantile congenital hemangioma, infantile congenital hemangioma, infantile congenital hemangioma, infantile congenital hemangioma. If you can say that 5 times fast, you probably know more plastic surgery than I do, but I doubt it. If you like learning about plastic surgery, remember to subscribe. Also like, because this was really good, and comment, because we love your comments. New videos coming up soon. Peace out.